Greetings, pilots. This video is about the Helibor frontline mode in 0.52. The frontline mode is at the moment played in Vietnam Operation Hinginu, Afghanistan Coast Province, and Balkans Kosovo. The main objective to win a game in frontline is to bring, in this case for the US, to bring tanks all the way to point one. You can of course go the different ways, over two, or over 3, over 7, or 4, or 5, the alternative roads. But your main goal will it be to bring to 1. If the game is not won before the time is over, which you can see here in the top corner, then the team wins, which have brought the tanks further than the other team. This base is captured with 100% from the beginning. Also you can see the incoming tanks. Behind 9, there's no base. The tank, when 9 is captured, the tanks will just appear and drive to point 9 and reinforce it. Notice, with only infantry in it, the capture point will look like this. It will have only the orange circle, like on the map. When the tanks drive in, the circle fills out, and the base is fully captured. On a fully captured base, this outer circle starts appearing, but only when the base is 100%. When this circle, you see this circle is moving, this circle will fill up all around, and when this happens, when the circle is completely full, it will send out a tank column to 9 or 6. It takes quite a while until the circle is full and the next column is appearing and driving to the next capture point. There's another possibility to get tank columns to the next capture point. You can easily force getting another tank column going to the next capture point by just simply capping this infantry. As you see already on the minimap, the orange column is already on the way, without having to wait. This also works if the capture point is not at 100% anymore. It will still send out tanks to the next, next capture point if it's captured. Landing zones can also be captured by non-standard infantry, for example with the mortar teams, RPG soldiers, or manpads. If you just drop them inside the capture point, they will capture it. They will definitely not position the AA position of the capture zone, but it will count as captures, and a tank column will move to this position if there's a connection. In this case, I'm going to capture landing zone 3, but it's connected to 3 different landing zones, which is kept by our one, and it's fully capped. Now, while you're capping it, you see there's 3 connections to it. And now, all 3 capture zones will send a tank column to it. So the enemy has to deal with 15 additional tanks. While the final tank column is on the way to the final capture point, to one and first victory condition, look at the victory progression bar. The tanks are nearly close to the victory, to our victory condition, and the bar will fill up completely, and the game is won. I hope you have an idea how the frontline mode works. Have fun winning your games this year. Bye.